Hello everyone, welcome back to HR 8 Minutes. Today we are cracking the code on employment contracts in India. So let's break down that legal jargon and turn it into a clear roadmap to success to your new job. So this video will give you the actual and practical understanding about employment contracts in India, its inclusions and types of employment contracts, and also how to prepare the contract. So without wasting much time, let's quickly get into all these details. And before all this, please subscribe the channel and hit that bell icon if you haven't till now. And by the end of the video, if you find it useful, then do share your feedback in the comment section and also like the video.
What is an employment contract?
So basically, an employment contract in India is like any other contract where you have an offer, acceptance, legal objects, free consent, considerations, and competent parties. It is usually considered as a bilateral agreement where there is a legal obligation to offer services from one end and payment for services from other end. So this relationship between employer and employee has always been a hot topic of discussion, and with time it has evolved because of the ever-evolving nature of employment. So an employment contract is a legal binding agreement between an employer and an employee that outlines the terms and conditions of their professional relationship. It serves as a crucial document that defines the rights, responsibilities, and expectations of both the parties during the course of employment. So, employment contracts typically include details such as job responsibilities, compensation, benefits, working hours, leave policies, termination procedures, and other relevant terms. So these contracts can vary in complexity based on the nature of employment and the specific need of the employer and employee.
Have a look on what should be included in an employment contract. Divided this into three categories: key components, key clauses, and legal considerations. So under key components, the first one is the parties involved, wherein we need to clearly define the employer and the employee and include details such as company's registered office address and the employee's designation. Second is about job description and responsibilities, wherein we need to provide a detailed description of the employee's role, duties and reporting structure, along with the clarity in job expectation, which helps in mitigating misunderstandings in the future. Is about the terms of employment, wherein we need to specify the start date, employment duration, and the conditions for renewal, along with clearly outlining the notice period for termination. Also, make sure your employment contract specifies the terms of your salary, because this eliminates any uncertainty about whether the new hire's first or second paycheck is due. So, some of the things to think about putting in your compensation package are: how the employees will be compensated, how does overtime pay work, which vacations are paid and which are unpaid, and how will be the employees be compensated, or is there any annual bonuses available, or any other such queries. Key clauses: the first one is confidentiality and non-compete, which clearly defines any confidentiality agreements to protect sensitive information, and if applicable, also outline non-compete clauses specifying duration and geographical limitations. Categories of intellectual property rights, which clarify the ownership of intellectual property created during employment, along with the state obligations regarding the non-disclosure of proprietary information. One is about termination clause, which specifies the conditions under which either party can terminate the contract, including the details about the notice period and any severance packages. Categories of dispute resolution, which outlines the process for resolving disputes, whether through arbitration, mediation or legal action, along with specifying the governing laws and jurisdiction. Under legal considerations, the first category is of offer letter versus employment contract, wherein the company needs to ensure that the employment contract comprehensively covers all terms and conditions, differentiating between the offer letter and detailed employment contract. Second one is about negotiation and consultation, which encourages both parties to carefully review and negotiate contract terms before signing and to seek legal advice for complex agreements. one is about changes to terms and conditions, which specify the process for making changes to the contract, and any amendments should be mutually agreed upon and documented. First category is about compliance with labor laws, which ensures that the employment contract complies with relevant labor laws such as Industrial Dispute Act, Minimum Wages Act, and any other as per applicability. Non-compliance may lead to legal consequences as well. Have a look on types of employment contract.
So beginning with the first one, as the name suggests, it is a contract that has got a set period and is usually for a period of less than 4 years. If the term of contract exceeds the tenure of 4 years, it is considered as permanent employment rather than the fixed term employment. So the reason why people offer fixed term employment is that it gives employment security and all the benefits that a permanent employment contract might provide them. So there are many nonsenses that people need to consider before drafting a fixed term employment contract. In the case where the employment document suggests any employee working for a tenure of 3 years, but he or she continues to work over the set period and no one raises an objection. In such situation, it is considered that there has been an implied extension agreement created between employee and employer. Second is the permanent employment contract, wherein in most situations, if it wasn't assigning an employment agreement, it is considered as permanent employment contract because it is the most prevalent and used mode of offering employment all across the nation. So employment contract in India is heavily dependent upon this type of employment because it is a driving force of our economy. And under this head, employment is considered to be ongoing until it is expressed to be terminated from either parties. And also, a permanent employment contract can cover full-time employment or part-time employment. Usually, all kinds of statutory benefits and rights are provided to employees of this contract. The third type, the name is quite suggestive of the fact that this kind of contract is ended only in the situation or scenarios where services are needed for a particular work or hours. So these kinds of employment can be offered on a daily, weekly or monthly basis. The pattern of work in this kind of employment is usually dependent upon the employer rather than the employer. Payments in such kind of employment are usually heavily dependent upon the kind of services the employer has rendered. Then we talk about the benefits and extra perks that other kinds of employment contracts enjoy. There isn't much that is delivered in this kind of employment agreement. There is no requirement of an employment contract bond or employment contract notice since it is an hourly basis task.
Moving on to the last part of our video, that is how to write an employment contract. The first part of writing an employment contract is to give your contract of employment a title so that the individual reviewing or signing authority knows what it is about. Secondly, in most employment contracts, it is stated who is entering into the contract. So consider writing your company name and the name of the person you are recruiting on a piece of paper. Thirdly, the federal and state government set some of the minimum terms and conditions for employment contracts. Working hours and severance benefits are included in these terms and conditions because terms and circumstances differ by area. So it's critical to review your state and local employment legislations. Next, to ensure that a new recruit understands what is expected of them, provide a description of their job responsibilities. You could add percentages to each responsibility if you wish to present a more detailed breakdown of obligations. Also, make sure your employment contract specifies the terms of your salary because this eliminates any uncertainty about whether the new hire's first or second paycheck is due. So some of the things to think about putting in your compensation package are how the employees will be compensated, how does overtime pay work, which vacations are paid and which are unpaid, and how will be the employees be compensated, or is there any annual bonuses available, or any other such queries. In the sixth point, the effective date, nature of employment, notice, employee termination, dispute process, applicable legislation, and severability are all common contract provisions in employment contracts. After you have finished the first draft of your employment contract, have it reviewed by an attorney or legal practitioner to ensure it complies with all applicable laws. This could help insulate your company from potential employment contract disputes. I hope now things are much clearer for you about the employment contract terms and applicability. I request you to please share your valuable feedback in comment section and do like and share the video, and also please subscribe the channel to get connected with HR Internist.